Alright, let's do this shit. I'm not fucking around anymore. I'm ornery, as you can tell. I apologize for the language. If you got parents at home, maybe give them a little earmuffs. We finished all the challenges but Suicide King. So many of the challenges crossed off that I could not even find it easily. This is Suicide King 3.0 and our seed. AE1M4KAN. I'm ready. This is my second. Yes, I like that. Apologies for hitting my microphone there. This is my second Suicide King run of the day. So this is my new fucking normal. I'm ready. I expect my shots to explode. Oh, I'll take it because it's weird. Even though I think it could end up killing us here. And I probably don't need to add any more elements of unreliable damage into the game. But anyway, I'm excited. This is my new normal. Which is my way of saying I expect my shots to explode when they get too close to enemies now. I expect to have to spend, you know, a lot of my mental energy trying to dodge my own detritus here. I'm excited. People ask me, by the way, Northern Line, why do you say detritus weird? That's how we fucking say it in this part of the world, okay? There's different pronunciations depending on where in the world you are. I think if you're in, you know, parts of the colonial world that aren't Canada or the United States, I suppose, you say, like, detritus? Something like that? We don't say that. We say detritus, okay? In fact, most of us just don't say it at all. It's a word that very few people find cause to really use all that often. I go out of my way. Probably because I like it and it makes me feel so fancy, you already know. I'm in the thesaurus from billowing to hidey hole. I don't know, it doesn't really make any sense. You get the idea, though. Alright. I still, this is my real voice right now, by the way. I mean, like, it's always my real voice, but this is my, this is how I want to talk. I'm not putting on airs here. Oh, come on. Like, I am genuinely trying to take care of business. That was very, very lucky on my part. I'm, okay. I really think that Mom's toenail would probably get me killed, so I don't mind, basically telling it to F off. Let's go fight our boss. It's the Widow. Widow should be pretty easy. Yeah, that, you know, prophecy came true. Tears plus shot speed up. I don't know if that really affects us too much at all here, but a relatively okay first floor. I'm learning what I need to make this run work. What do we need to make Suicide Kings work for me? Sure, you know what? I don't think Eve's Birdfoot is that good either. Let's take Mysterious Paper. What do I need to make my ideal Suicide King run work? HP. I need a fuck ton of HP. I need Dark Bum, or Satanic Bible, or Book of Revelations, trinkets like the Left Hand, which I think we had last time, but we blew it. Trinkets like Rosary Bead. Trinkets like Demon Tail. Anything, any combination of those items that we can get here would make my life a lot easier. Apart from that, insanely high damage, the ability to fly. I'm just listing shit that would be great right now. I mean, it's great on all runs, but I don't think it's ever been more integral than it will be on this run right here. Map, compass, things along these lines. They'll help. They really will. Demon Tail, there you go. If we can only get one of those things that I asked for, probably wouldn't choose this one above all else, but here we are. This room strikes me as a fucking kill box. Let's be smart here. We also found our secret room as a result of that, which is very surprising to me. And if we play our cards insanely correctly, we might be able to even blow up these statues. But I might not risk that too much. Now there is, apart from the chests that are in that sweet area up there. Oh, come on. There's also a... Oh, we already got the Tinted Rock, right, okay. There we go, that was good. And then we can probably use one bomb here, and this will allow us to access all this. This is nice, this could have gone worse. That's good. That is maybe great, or maybe terrible. Tears down is not so bad. Health down is terrible. Alright. Not an enormous fan of this room. Doesn't look like we'll be able to make our shop worthwhile, so let's move it along and fight Monstro here. Monstro, like Widow, is pretty much an ideal boss fight for us here. really hoping... That was terrible. Really hoping to get an HP upgrade of some sort, maybe an all stats. Pentagram is also great. And... Dark Bum. Yeah, okay. That's big. We need it. Sincerely. Health de- Oh, well, check this out. Wait a minute, let me think about this. If I do this right, I should be able to get the ability to fly as well. I don't want to take that in case it's telepills. So what if we take this? Don't die. Health up. Dark Bomb. Balls of Steel, that's pretty lucky. Now let's head down to the next floor. These are incredibly big moves for us here. The fact that we can fly helps us out, although I do have to constantly keep in mind the fact that I could still... Oh my god, it makes it now impossible for us to find secret rooms. Well, that's something I didn't expect. Please tell me that it still hits enemies when it touches them directly. Thank god. Well, it's gonna be a little annoying, but nonetheless, Dark Bomb is a huge pickup for us here. And the ability to fly should help. It at least, when there's rooms like this, otherwise, were it not for the ability to fly, we could find ourselves in a pretty dire circumstance, you know, having to constantly dodge these guys. Now we can just opt out, and we can say, you know what, I'm just gonna hide out over the over the gaps here. This should be enough for us to win. We got a long way to go, obviously. But in theory, this should be enough. That was very risky. Yeah, especially with the pentagram, like, that last floor might end up being, like, truly incredible for us. So Magic Fingers is a pretty good item for us as well, as it has been... Wow, pardon me. As it has been on a lot of these challenges. So now we're pretty much just going to use bombs to look for secret rooms, I guess. Yeah, I probably wouldn't find it over there. That was a pretty lucky shot. I'm very excited, is what I'm trying to get at here. I'm a little bit lost for words. Not that I'm overwhelmed or anything like that, but I'm just a little bit lost for words because I'm feeling like we might have actually fulfilled all those needs that I asked for on the last floor, like, nearly instantly. Which is, not instantly, but quickly, which is pretty amazing. I don't really care about this orbital, but we have it. We might as well look around for second secret rooms. Because we're certainly in the market for red hearts. I wonder if we should be able to land one here. It's like our range is so high, it's nearly impossible for us to actually get a shot to land where we want it to. Maybe we do, like, some weirdness like this. Oh, come on now. There we go. We'll try to look for our regular... I mean, we should explore regardless. Because... Well, we can find stuff like this. This two-key room. You never know if this is going to be awesome for us. And our secret room is right there. I don't know what two does. Might reroll everything on the room? Let's give it a shot. It rerolls everything on the room. We get a credit card, which allows us to buy anything we want for free from the store. Speed downgrade is not great. Should we buy Magic Fingers? I mean, it doesn't seem that important when we could use this on the next floor to maybe buy something better. I know I said Magic Fingers would be useful, but we could get something even more meaningful, maybe, if we don't buy something. I don't know. Just because we have a credit card, it feels like we have an impetus to use it right away. But I don't know if that's necessarily true. I think we might gain more by not. Wow. Bad luck. Ah, very, very good luck. That goat head could be enormous for us in a variety of interesting ways. I'll tell you what, we'll walk into our shop because what we'd be leaving behind is the world card, which on a numeric level, it was the world. On a numeric level, monetary, it's not really worth that much. The credit card is worth 15 cents, basically. I think we save it. You can also use credit card on deals with the devil. So we'll see what we have here, and if there's a great deal, maybe we'll take it for free. I kind of like the idea of taking the pact here. Like, what if we take the pact for free? Oh, snap! Does it work on both of them? Probably not, but... It works on both of them. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. So we just got Goathead and Pack for free, and hopefully that's a useful tip. I can't take credit for that. I saw it on the subreddit literally about 15 minutes before recording this episode. PSA, credit card works on the Devil Rooms, so it's a shame that maybe we didn't have Blank Card in our shop, because then we could have just gotten every deal with the Devil item for free forever, which would have been pretty good as far as I'm concerned. But the Pact, not only does that give us extra damage for free, but of course it also gave us the extra two Spirit Arts for free, and now we have a real chance to become Guppy, especially with Goathead. This is pretty amazing. That might end up being the kind of, well, I don't really want to call it ingenuity, that'd be a little dishonest, but let's just say it anyway. It might end up being the kind of ingenuity required for me to actually have a better chance to win a run like this. Now, our HP is still not amazing, but it is worth noting that we didn't really get anything red heart-wise on the last floor. So, like, it's not like we're in a bad position HP-wise. We have Dark Bomb. It's just that, you know, on the last floor, the game didn't really play nice with us. It didn't really give us anything that we could use to actually benefit from Dark Bomb-wise and all that. Oh, that could have gone better, but we're fine. That's for you, Dark Bomb. Should use Guppy's head. Nice. I was going to say we should make a bridge here, but it really doesn't matter, does it? We'll be checking for secret rooms again. The second secret room is so important for us here. Even more important than the regular secret room. I should go to the arcade? I think the obvious... Whoa. The obvious question is, I just don't know what I'd be looking for, really. That went very well as well. Plenty of keys. I'll admit, I don't love the idea of this 2. I don't know what 2 does, but I think it's just a little too risky. I'm liking our run right now. Let's see what we got in our shop. If it's blank card, I'm gonna be pissed, because credit card was so good for us. It's not the blank card. It's a ladder, spirit hearts. I think we'd be best to buy the spirit hearts. We can't buy the red heart, unfortunately, otherwise I would love to. This is definitely shaping up to like look like a boss area up here. Yeah. Our flies, do our flies explode? Or do they just do a lot of damage because we have Ipecac and, you know, all the other stuff? Second secret room, please. This is the second secret room, which it is. We can just leave this floor as far as I'm concerned. Cool, that's acceptable. Should probably make sure I get that. Yeah, I'm ready to go. We might gamble on those eventually, but not yet. Wow, our flies do so much damage. Guppy's head, it might actually be like the ideal item for us here. Do we know? There should be like a health upgrade maybe in here. Balls of steel, that's great. Health up, yeah. We may end up using that. Guppy's hairball, Judas's shadow. I think we should take Guppy's hairball. There's something to be said about Judas's shadow as well, but I'm not going to take it. Bombs are key, tears down. We'll take the magician with us. Okay, so we are only one Guppy item away from generating a ton of flies. And if we are generating a ton of flies, I think a lot of our problems are solved. Because as you can see right now, well, as you saw against Mega Fatty, Mega Fatty is one of those bosses in the game. Oh, careful. Mega Fatty is one of those bosses in the game who has the most HP. So to be able to kill Mega Fatty with just our flies in like a second was ridiculous. And amazing. And if we can make that happen consistently, all we need on this run is a Guppy item and HP. That's like that. That's the recipe for success that we have right now. Now it would be nice if we can get some more red hearts so Dark Bomb could actually do its effing job. I have no, it's not Dark Bomb's problem right now that, we haven't really gotten many payouts. It's entirely the game's inability to actually give me red hearts. The other thing we should do is kind of counterintuitively enough. Ah, come on. Probably try to kill as many enemies as possible with our bullets like that, so that we can just kind of pocket the extra flies as profit, if you know what I mean. Like, in being able to do that, then we'll have a fly army for rooms where you know, our safety is a little bit less guaranteed. Like this one, for example, where I don't want to shoot necessarily because I need to maneuver 100%. And on this room, you know, rooms where we can take out enemies from afar much more easily. If Fine by me, thank you. Trying to give all my hearts to my dark bum here. Okay. I like it. I don't mind fighting greed. Steam sale's definitely gonna... I mean, we already had a lot of money, but it's gonna open up the ability to pretty much buy whatever we want. I don't want to use my my bombs to kill those skulls because... there would not be a second secret room there. Because I want to make sure that we have as many bombs as possible to find the second secret room, because it could be worth 4 spirit hearts, you know? That's way more meaningful than blowing up a skull or two. Great damage on my part there. Really proud of myself. All right, Judgment, you could help me out a great deal here. Red hearts, then like an HP upgrade, please. It's a key. Never gonna look down on a key, but would maybe prefer... Oh, it's so good. Blue map is actually, like, I can't justify any complaining about that Judgment anymore, because blue map allows me to find the second secret room without having to waste bombs, which is so much more meaningful. No, we still gotta stick with Demon's Tail, even though Lucky Rock would probably give us a ton of consumables. Look at how quickly we killed the adversary. Like, that's really the draw for me on this run, is just get as many flies as possible. Oh, snap! We have to. Even though it puts us low on HP, now we're guppy. Our fly game is gonna be out of control. We cannot die. Like, by that I mean, we can die. If we die, we're really fucked, though. This is the run that we've been waiting for. All we need to have happen here is red hearts. If we can get Dark Bum to just pay out. This is actually one of those weird situations where it might actually be in the best interest for us to get to that boss rush room and actually fight on it, because this is not access to the second secret room, by the way, but it might be in our best interest to do that because there will be a ton of red hearts dropped on that fight. Now, it'll be a little risky, maybe. Just kind of hoping maybe we'd get some red hearts out of that, but you know, it might be possible that because we have Demon's Tail, we're getting a lot less red hearts. Maybe I actually should replace it. But I guess I should be blowing up skulls more often now. Because maybe we'll have a much better chance to get black hearts out of our skulls. Maybe I've been making a bit of a tactical mistake here. Maybe, maybe not. Well, okay, I'll tell you what. The Hierophant card is pretty solid. The Moon card is really good. What I will do is probably end up using the Moon card to teleport out of the Boss Rush Room. The Boss Rush Room. Surprisingly weird word to say. So we could basically get a free item, or we could choose to fight it if we want to. I don't know why I would, though. I know why I would, to get red hearts. But anyway, let's ignore that. By the way, the reason I'm using bombs instead of my Ipecac shots to break these skulls is just because I don't want to mess around with, I don't want to mess around with the, Ipecac shots, pardon me, that could actually end up, you know, coming back to bite me in the ass. Ooh. Vision. Probably, like, yeah, basically map plus compass there, I guess. We are running out of bombs. Ah, we got Dry Baby, that's a great item. And this is our second secret room, like, up here. Let me just try putting a bomb down instead. I always lose track of where the secret room's supposed to be here. There we are. I know I should play this, but I'm so lazy about it. So we'll just stay up here for a minute, then take it back. There we go. Red hearts. Man, red hearts are not dropping. Maybe, I'm starting to think I really should just drop, ooh. Like, I really should just drop a Demon Tail. I'm having a clash of Demon Tail right now. I'm debating it in my mind right now. Two of clubs. Hey, we got, you know, 2 free bombs there. Let's use one right here. Nice. Let's do it. I'm ready. Oh, it's the mom fight already. Oh, we'll totally teleport out. Yeah. Well, maybe not teleport out. We might actually fight for it. I didn't realize we were so far ahead. Plenty of time. Take the Polaroid. Devil Room. It's Krampus. Honestly, nothing could convince me to get rid of Guppy's Head. Guppy's Head gives us so much damage. 3 flies was almost enough to kill Krampus by itself. quarter, Aries, Ankh, Butterbean. I think we take the Ankh, and I think we maybe end up actually fighting our enemies here. As much as it might seem ridiculous, I really think we're going to get a lot of red hearts here, and this is going to give me the HP required with Dark Bum to save the day here, which I'm pretty excited about. There's also, I saw a Spirit Heart just drop randomly up there. Plus, like, we're the added benefit is that we, the added benefit is that we have, the Ankh now. So if we die, we'll come back, and we'll come back with a decent amount of Spirit Hearts. I'm not sure what order will we come back. That was almost terrible. That heart was hit by the spikes somehow. This is the guy you want to kill right off the bat. The fact that I seem incapable of doing that is not making me a happy camper right now. That's the other thing, is we'll have like permanent Polaroid invincibility now. Okay, be smart. Hit him. Nice, better, better. At least, you know, you gotta hit him in the vulnerable spot, but that's okay. This guy's a little tricky. We gotta stay far enough away that we don't get screwed on him. Not as easy as it might seem. Gotta kinda catch him from behind like that. Staying alive, staying alive. There we go, finally. So there's still gonna be those hearts that we have to take care of. Thank you, Dry Baby. I guess the hearts will take care of themselves in time, thanks to that. This is probably one of the few rooms in the entire game that's large enough that I'm really gonna desire a range upgrade. So I'm not gonna sweat the fact that right now I'm like, oh, my range is so low. It doesn't really matter. That was dumb on my part, but hey, invincibility. It might, you know, if we ever get uncomfortable in this room, we can teleport out. We get one free item. Not really free, I guess. Costs a buck 05, but we get one item for finishing. May or may not be a good item, so we shouldn't bank on that being good. I would bank on it being shitty. That's the norm. Actually, Norm from Cheers is the norm, but, you know, it's a norm. And annoying as well. Good. I mean, this... If we can beat Boss Rush, you would assume that we should have a pretty good chance to beat Mom's Heart, at least, and then it's just Isaac. Just Isaac. Just Isaac! You think Chris Isaac is ever, like, offended that, you know, the Binding of Isaac came out, and now he's only, like, the fourth most popular Isaac after Isaac Hayes and Ashley McIsaac, the Cape Breton fiddler? Maybe that's just a Canadian thing. Maybe the famous Cape Breton fiddler is just a Canadian thing. Just a hunch there. I think I might be correct about that. That guy's still alive, huh? I would like that bomb fly to die. Yeah, thank you, Dry Baby. That'll sort it out. That also killed both of those monstrosities for me. So I'm realizing that we probably do need to get rid of Demon Tail. I don't want to give it up for nothing, though. Like... Because it is giving me a better chance of getting black hearts, and we've gotten a decent amount of black hearts here. But it's nerfing my ability to actually use Dry Bum. Or not Dry Bum, to Dark Bum. Got my bums and my babies confused. That can lead to disaster. This all being said, we're fine right now. We've actually gained, I think, a little bit of HP for our troubles here. If we're Guppy... Oh, you know what? I'm just realizing this now. But actually becoming Guppy doesn't do shit for us with respect to our Ipecac shots because they're not primary tiers. Now, I didn't realize this, but people have told me that there's kind of a second measure that you need to take care of when it comes to generating flies, whether you get the mulligan, whether you become Guppy, etc., etc. Only your primary tiers generate flies. With Ipecac, I don't think Ipecac counts as a primary tier the same way like Technology 2 doesn't. So we might not even generate more flies as a result of being Guppy. Which is incredibly disappointing to me. Oh my god, we're actually losing a decent amount of HP here. Be smart. Kill this guy, he's dead. Hurt that guy, he's gonna be dead. Oh my god, that didn't hit. Good. Not good. You need to be smarter. We have about as much HP now as we would if we respawned with the Ankh. That's not an encouraging place to be, necessarily. Maybe we will end up giving away Demon Tail for free. Because we should be getting way more red hearts than we actually are now. Wow, thank you, Bloat. Oh my god. I think the mask, oh, it's not quite dead. Now it's dead. Oh, come on. I am still, like, sadly finding myself nearly begging for range upgrades. Okay, we're on the horseman. We're almost done. Time will tell if this is the decision that's gonna, you know, do something for us on this run, or if it's gonna lose this run for us, but keep in mind, if we win with the Ankh, that's a win because of this boss rush room. I wasn't doing this to be cocky. This legitimately was, like, a strategy play for me. Oh my god! My reflection! Fudge off! How does death have so much HP here? Just be dead. You're already dead. Just rejoin the fucking fade here. Oop. Okay, I think Guppy's hairball finished the job there. Good. 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 War. You need to F the F off, dog. Like, for real, though. Ooh. How are there still you? How are there still you? Good. We got the speed. We got the speed. We got the power. I'm not a good singer, okay? Just, you know, live with it, as I have for my whole life. Thank you, Dry Baby. You always gotta say thank you, Dry Baby. Oh, just to make sure that it actually, you know, knows that you appreciate it. Just good manners, you know? I'm in rapt attention right now. That was the dumbest damage I've taken all fight. It just got right next to him. We're done, we're done. And we got Peeper's Eye, which is acceptable, I guess. And did we have anything? Maybe we could take value Krampus's head? No. Okay, so we're down to the next floor. Whether or not that was worth it is a tricky question that remains to be seen. No question about that. Oh, good. Curse of the Lost. So even our blue moon or blue map won't be useful here. So I'm going to drop Demon Tail. It's going to be an experiment. Many people might be disagreeing with me, but the fact that we've seen no red hearts really, really makes me think that Demon Tail is precluding them from showing up. I'll check. Yeah, yeah, that's an acceptable pickup. It changes all of our spirit hearts to black hearts. Then we get another spirit heart on the way back in there. Alright. And we might as well take Umbilical Cord. It's not like we're doing anything else with it right now. We could try to blow up those things down there, but I think it's a tall order. Is Peeper's Eye, like, is its damage a product of our damage? Because it seems to be pretty good right now. This is you, Dry Bum. That's a spirit heart right there. Go for it, buddy. Thank you. Ooh. Come on. Pheromones is okay. Come on. Are you a wizard? That is not what I'm looking for. But, well, why am I still exploring if that's not what I'm looking for? Because I think our flies will probably kill any enemy that we really desire to kill. If we don't get any red hearts after dropping Demon's Tail, I'm going to be pissed. There's another half heart. I don't think that'll make Demon Baby or Bum Friend pay out. Dark Bum. One of these days, I'll get that right. And you'll be sorry. You'll all be sorry. I don't think that's worth it. Because I don't know if our flies would be able to carry the damage there until, Oh, Are You a Wizard is already done. Man, these flies are good. I really don't want to pick up HP for myself because that would ruin my permanent Polaroid invincibility, which is a big part of the draw for me right now on this run. That was really bad. A big part of the draw for me on this run is the ability to pretty much kill anything I want, and if I get hit, well, I take a little damage, and then I'm invincible for a minute or two. By a minute or two, of course, I mean about, you know, 4 seconds, but that does make a bit of a difference sometimes. That was not a good dodge, that was a lucky dodge, but it worked. And again, anytime we can carry flies and not have to worry about using our existing flies to do damage is, it's a great time. Could have gone better. Ah, could have gone way better. But Dark Bomb's there for me. Ooh. This is a room I'm not gonna F around with too much. Yes! The red hearts! Thank you. And he carries that balance down to the next floor as well, so... if we end up being at like an odd interval that doesn't pay out, it doesn't really matter. Yeah. I'm just gonna let the flies take care of that one. See, that's why I value this run so highly. That's why I love those flies right now. I am gonna take meat, even though it's gonna ruin our invincibility, I think. Our invincibility is not really worth all that much to me right now. And it's a little bit more survivability and a little bit more damage, which makes our flies do even more damage. So I'm assuming they're gonna be able to basically shit on whichever bosses we want them to shit on. Which is all of them. Should go to our secret room. Probably will. Nothing else to do with my bombs, basically. I'll probably go to the curse room. I had a feeling you were seeing me for a reason. Oh, that was really bad. At least we saved a bomb. Okay. Yeah, I'll check it out. Wow. At least there's a red heart in here. Nice! We might get super lucky and be able to bomb our way out. I kind of doubt it, but it could happen. Yeah. Oh well. Let's go up and around, even though it's looking increasingly unlikely this is going to be the right way to go. By my guesses, at least. Again. I kind of used my options not perfectly there. That's okay. As long as we can save our flies, that's all that matters. I'm loving you right now, Dark Bum. You are still pretty much single-handedly the reason I think I'm able to have a chance here. This is not a one run, by the way. We have every item that I would consider necessary in order to have a one run as a Suicide King challenge, but I don't think this is a one run yet. I think we're still, like, not quite there. As a result of the fact that all it takes is one truly terrible room for me to lose, like, all of this HP that I've, you know, built up. Oh, thank you. That's really good luck. Dark Bum, I had a feeling you were gonna show me something there. Got something in my front pocket for you. Why don't you reach on in my pocket and see what it is? Give it a squeeze and say, how do you do? Got something in my Dark Bum for you. Ew, gross. Where the hell is our... I put it in the same freaking place that time. There it is, down at the bottom there. That's store credit. Can we use store credit on a deal with the devil? We'll walk into our devil room and see if we can. Oh, this is like totally the wrong way to go, by the way. Alright. Yeah, because if we can take a free deal with the devil, we won't have any more deals with the devil over the course of the entire game, but I guess I'll take it with me anyway, just in case. I don't know. Let's be honest, umbilical cord wasn't really doing that much for us anyway. I love you. Where the fudge is our boss room then? Why did I assume that our boss room had to be over by that second secret room? I had a weird brain fart there. The boss is quite clearly on the left side, but I assumed that he had to be on the right because that's where the second secret room is. Not a very shrewd move. There's no reason to take this health downgrade. I was theory crafting some ideas. There are no good ideas for this. We're not going to lose 1 HP, unless we take that pill. Kind of wish we didn't use so many flies there, but it's not the end of the world. Ooh, this is the room that we don't fuck around with. That was really bad. Oh, okay, well, an Eternal Heart. It's not that meaningful, but it's not terrible either, I guess. Look at that homing fucking bullshit. Ugh, infamy. Probably not that meaningful, but I appreciate it nonetheless. Oh, that was terrible. I'll admit, by the way, this fight is longer than I expected it would be, and now I'm a little scared. It really sucks that our Ipecac shots don't generate more flies. I did not know, though, that Peeper's Eye would block shots as it came in here. That's pretty cool. That was really dumb. But we've lived. Come on, Dark Bum, work with me here. All right, well, we're going up to the cathedral. Either way, let's do it! I'm excited! This could be it! I love you! Pay out with more red hearts, please. Keys. I said please, not keys! I said please! Just don't give me fleas and we'll be okay. Oh, I was just gonna say, maybe you can give me a lover's card. Work on the dark bomb. Yeah! Okay, yeah, well, that should allow us a better chance of seeing where the boss is. If I had to guess, I actually would say that far right is conceivable here. Or bottom left. It's kind of hard to see thanks to the transparency, but actually, I think bottom left is a little bit more likely now that I look at it. Good. Magician, not so good. Yeah. We had to check anyway, but it was pretty clear to me at a second glance of the map that that's where it's going to be. Which is fine because it does take us through the... well, it takes us adjacent, at least, to the second secret room, which could contain a lot of red hearts. Now, I'll admit, I don't love the idea of going into our curse room. Probably should have flown in, then used the moon card to get out of the curse room for free. But I didn't, so here we are. We got to save all of our HP for this attempt here. Nice little assortment of flies following me around here. Only one Daddy Longlegs? Save your flies for Isaac. I think we're gonna do it, guys. Oh, come on. Come on. There we go. I think we have a very, very real chance of winning this. I have to not throw, and that's a bit of a challenge for me. That's helpful. It's not really the room that I wanted, but that's okay. So we'll use our magician card. We'll get up in there pretty quick. Ooh. We're not going to generate too many more flies. I was really hoping for a bit more fly love out of this. But he's going to do his thing very soon. We're safe in this corner, because there was a beam in the opposite corner. That was very dumb of me. What I did there was very dumb. We lived. That doesn't mean it was smart. Similarly, that was exceptionally dumb. You are finding ways to throw in a situation that should not be likely. Almost did it again. Whew. This is your damage time. Oh. Thank you, magician card. I love you, magician card. Hide out, hide out. We're safe in this corner for now. This is our win. Finally. Finally. That's all the challenges, and we get the Suicide King card. Okay. All crossed off. Yes, they are. That was still not that easy. That I'll put my vote in for Suicide King as the hardest challenge. We scummed head trauma. We got lucky on beans and solar system, probably, and family man. But for now, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.